John, so what have you been up to since your fight with Ruslan? You've been in the gym?
In the gym, training.
Shadid, congratulations on the win.
Thank you. He's putting together a great game plan for whoever we fight next. And Shadid's a hell of a trainer, man. And it showed. We followed the game plan and it came out victorious against Ruslan.
Okay. Did you watch a Conor McGregor, Nate Diaz fight?
I did.
What did you think? You're a former wrestler yourself. Yeah. You actually could do boxing and MMA.
I believe the right guy won that fight. Although.
Yeah, Nate won. I know.
I believe the right guy won the fight. Although, running in MMA is not like evading in boxing. It looks horrible in MMA. And I don't like the way Conor won. And I think they should have a trilogy. And this nonsense about him coming down to 155, that's BS. Fight the man where you had your last two fights at.
And he carried the weight pretty well?
He did carry the weight well. He fought a tactical fight. But again, in MMA, the way he evaded him, it didn't look right. To me, I was turned off by it. It looked like he was afraid.
Mayweather McGregor.
Oh, yeah, you can't compare that, man. McGregor is good at what he does, and Mayweather, the man at what he does. So you can't compare those two different beasts. If you put Floyd in the MMA in the octagon, they'll have a problem. But if you put McGregor in the ring, he's going to have a big problem.
What are you weighing right now? You look in shape. You look like you're ready to fight tonight.
I'm ready to fight right now. We had to, man. I don't go too far from my weight. We work hard. We work diligently on keeping our weight and staying in shape.
Who would you want to fight, John? I mean, 47 is so deep, from Amir Khan to Kell Brook to...
Mind you that I am 40, but 47 is right there for me. There's a lot of fights out there. I wouldn't mind, right now Ricky Burns at 140. Yeah, that's a good fight. I'll go to his neck of the woods if we need to go over there to fight.
Knock him out, take his belt.
You know, we'll get on with him. If I had to go to 47, you know, Danny Garcia, Keith Thurman, those are all names that you put my name in the hat with those names, and they're going to be a good fight. You know, Sean has had a great fight with Keith, and I think it'll be a great fight between me and Keith as well.
Danny Garcia and Terrence Crawford had a beef.
They did. Terrence Crawford, he's a good fighter. The problem is, you know, I can't take anything away from Victor Postol. He's a hell of a fighter, and he beat someone that I couldn't beat, which was Lucas Matisse. Lucas Matisse beat me. He beat him. Regardless, you got to respect every fighter. But Terrence Crawford, I don't know if he's going to be at 140. But if he is, I'm his mandatory for the WBO. So
what happens in a fight, you and Terrence?
It's going to be a hell of a fight. It's going to be a war. I think Terrence is a hell of a fighter, though.
He's a great fighter. He's a switch hitter, and he's super talented.
Terrence, if you're up for it, I'm up for it.
You know what I always tell people, John? Hello. No one has ever punched me as hard as John Molina.
It holds true, and we'll do it again later. You look like you've been cutting weight.
Stay tuned. Peace to report. .com. Money Step Back.
Reporting. And you can follow him on Twitter.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Secback. Take a step back, cause it's a step back.